Hi guys, thanks for checking in with STTOP. Today we're talking about how to get to the places that we all need to go without putting more carbon into the air. Being driven everywhere is weird, and us humans are obsessed with cars. Two separate studies conducted in 2013 revealed that half of household car trips in Sydney and two-thirds in London were under 5 kilometres. You could cover that distance in like 10 minutes on a bike. Australia's transport sector is the third largest source of Australia's greenhouse gas emissions, amounting to 21% of national emissions in 2023. Since 2005, transport sector greenhouse gas emissions have increased by 19% and are currently projected to be the largest in Australia by 2030. And cars? They're responsible for roughly half of those transport emissions. Australian cars emit about the same as Queensland's entire coal and gas-fired electricity supply. But how do I get around without using a car or like an Uber? I do have the solution. Feet. Don't you worry. I too forgot that I had feet. But mine are gonna need some inspiration, so I'm gonna talk to someone who knows all about moving with feet. Yeah. Beau Miles is a runner and a kayaker. He builds things with his hands and maybe his feet. We don't know. He sleeps in trees, and look, here he is, running with a shovel. Hi, Beau. So for those who haven't seen your videos, it seems like you do a lot of crazy stuff. My question is, what and why?
Everything that I do is just geared around maximizing my time on Earth. Some people will know me as an adventurer. When I was a younger bloke, I just wanted to be as far away from home as possible, doing things that I'd never done before and that scared the hell out of it. So I'd go away and do these things, these big paddles and big runs in parts of the world I'd never been, and eventually came back home realizing that I really loved Australia, and now I do a lot more local stuff. A mile an hour is when I run around my block 1 mile every hour for 24 hours, including 3 miles at the start, and lo and behold, that creates a marathon. And it's been repeated thousands of times on YouTube and by running groups. So I think that's really neat because most people can do a mile an hour, whether they're walking or in a pram or in a wheelchair or whatever. You could do it on a pogo stick or do it on crutches.
A mile an hour is a great example of how little steps can add up to big things. So, Beau, what inspired you to take those little steps? Is there like a point that you remember where everything became clear?
I laid on my back in the world's oldest river, which is in the center of Australia, the Fink River. It's about 400 million years old. You got the sand under your back. It's an ephemeral river. It only runs every couple of years. I was looking up to the stars, and you can think that, yes, humans are very insignificant. But then you think, I'm laying this river because of climate change and because things are changing based on us. My anxieties then evaporate if I just try and think about my 5K or 10K radius, because they're the things I can plant trees in. I can stop using my car in that radius. I can do all these things that are tangible.
More than 20 million cars are registered in Australia. And with a population of 26 million, we're coming close to a car per person. That blows my mind. Not in a good way. I do want to be more active, and I want to reduce my reliance on things like Uber. You know, I want to reduce my carbon footprint. But where would you encourage me to start? Whether it's mentally or logistically, or even if I'm just like easing my way into things.
Just start by walking, and then you might put a jog in or start riding. You're probably doing yourself the biggest favor of your life. Walking is beautiful. You can think, you can look around, you can navigate, use your phone, do whatever. But either way, trust your body. It's awesome.
So when we wake up tomorrow, we're all just gonna collectively think of you, Beau. Do you wanna give us some words of encouragement?
Try and make the ordinary remarkable, because we all have the capacity to do that. Just start by walking.
Thanks, Beau. I really appreciate you being here.
Good on you, folks.
All right, so after all that, what are we doing? Get your feet out and get walking. If you're not a runner like Beau, there are other forms of movement. Using a bike instead of a car for short trips could reduce your travel emissions by 75%. And if you're not a biker, then I don't know, scooters or rollerblades and pogo sticks. So ditch the car and find your feet. Mine are below the desk, I promise. I do have feet. Post your progress. You can use the hashtag #stop2030 or #feetnotfuel.